Three, two, one, action.
The great cattle tree. One man was walking into the rainforest. Moments before, the forest had been alive with the sounds of squeaking birds and howling monkeys. Now, all was quiet as the creature watched the man and wondered why he had come. The man stopped and pointed to a great hippo tree. Then he took the axe he carried and struck the trunk of the tree.
Wah, wah, wah.
The sound of the blow ran through the forest. The wood of the tree was very hard.
Sharp, 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 sharp.
The man wiped off the sweat that ran down his face and neck.
Wah, wah, sharp, wah, sharp.
Soon, the man grew tired. He sat down to rest at the foot of the great hippo tree. Before he knew it, he hit a horn of the forest had lured him to sleep. A boa constrictor lived in the hippo tree. It slithered down its trunk to where the man was sleeping. He looked at the gash the axe had made in the tree. Then, the huge nest slid very close to the man, and he's in his ear.
Senor, this tree is a tree of miracle. This is my home, where generations of my ancestors have lived to not closing down.
A butterfly flew near the sleeping man's ear.
Senor, I will hold in this cape tree. I will fly from the tree, and flower to flower, collecting for pollen. In this way, we pollinate the tree and flowers throughout the rainforest. You see, all living things depend on the weather.
A troop of monkeys scampered down from the canopy of the cape tree. They shouted to the sleeping man.
Senor, we have seen the way of man. You chop down one tree, then come back for another and another. The root of this great tree will be withered and die, and there will be nothing left to harm the earth and place. When the heavy rain comes, the soil will be washed away, and the forest will come a desert.
A toucan flew down from the canopy.
Senor, you must not cut down this tree. We have flown over the rainforest and seen what happens once you begin to chop down this tree. Many people sit on the land. They set fire to clean down the brush, and soon the forest disappears. Where once there was life and beauty, only black and smothering greens remain.
Some bright and small tree frog crawled along the edge of a leaf in a squeaky voice. They piped in the man's ear.
Senor, a rainflow is mean, really large, many really light. You will live many us. Only if you show down is this a different tree.
A jaguar had been sleeping along a branch in the middle of the tree because his spotted coat blend into the goblet light and shadow of the understory. No one had noticed him. Now he leapt down and padded silent over the sleeping man. He growled in his ear.
Senor, the couple tree is home to my bears and animals. If you cut its down, where will I find my dinner?
A tree porcupine swept down from branch to branch and whispered to the man.
not. Do you not know what we, animal and human, need in order to live oxygen? And senor, do you know what tree produce oxygen? If you cut down the forest, you will destroy that which gives us our life.
An editor climbed down the cripple tree with her baby climbing to her back. The mama editor said to the sleeping man,
Senor, you are chopping down this tree with no doubt for the future. And surely you know what that happens tomorrow depends upon that you do today. The big man tells you to chop down a beautiful tree. He does not think of his own children, who tomorrow must live in a world without trees.
A three-toed sloth had begun climbing down from the canopy when the man first appeared. Only now did she reach the ground, floating ever so slowly. Over the sleeping man, she spoke in her deep and lazy voice.
Señor, how much is beauty worth? Can you live without it? If you destroy the beauty of the rainforest, of what would you feast your eyes?
A child from the Yonamamo tribe, who lived in the rainforest, knelt over the sleeping man. He murmured in his ear,
Señor, we enjoy a great place. Look at us with new eyes.
The man awoke with a start. Before him stood the rainforest child, and all around him, staring, were the creature who depends upon the great Kipus tree. What wondrous and rare animals they were. The man looked about and saw the sun-jeweled amethyst, the dark green forest, strange and beautiful plants seeming to dangle in the air, suspended from the great Kipus tree. The man smelled the fragrant perfume of their flower. He felt the steamy mist rising from the forest floor, but he heard no sounds, for the creatures were strangely silent. The man stooped and picked up his axe. He swung back his arm as though to strike the tree. Suddenly, he stopped. He turned and looked at the animals and the child. He has tied it. Then he dropped the axe and walked out of the rainforest. Thank you.
Thank you.